welcome to a special emergency broadcast of WFWF View 62 of the Batshit Bonanza. Yes, the original Batshit Bonanza had to be cut short because I was not feeling well. But that's not to worry. We did get a couple of good matches on that one, and we're definitely going to get some fun out of this one tonight. Just to hold you all over until we could get back things running tomorrow. Fingers crossed for the official W3 channel over at NDE Plays at twitch.tv/. But I want to thank y'all for joining us here. We are going to get things started here with some tag team action. It's actually going to be for an international Lucha Libre Tag Team Championship held by the team of Austin Tyrell and Mason Marks, also known as the Campeonato de Parejas. They're going to be facing Los Muertos. Should be a lot of fun. We get things going up and running. We're having a good time. Hey! Give it up for the U62 house band. They're pretty great. Oh shit, I forgot to turn off entrances, didn't I? All right, let's see what I can come up with in the span of a couple of seconds. Here we go! Here we go with Los Muertos. The team of Benny and Juan Ramon. Looking pretty darn dapper in their makeup. Hopefully coming home with some beautiful Campeonatos de Parejas. Oro. They're full of energy, these two. They are very calculated. Now they've got this opportunity at the offices of the CWLLM, the Come Watch Lucha Libre Mijo / Mija. And their opponents. Campeonatos de Parejas, the Dungeon Brothers. They look good. Oh, careful there. Don't hit the pinball machine or the air hockey table. Team of Austin and Mason. Alright, here we go. Everything's off right there. It is the Campeonatos de Parejas Tag Team Championships. The following contest is a tag team set for one fall. Oh, this is exciting. And Los Muertos ready to go. As the Dungeon Brothers ready to put those belts on the line. Will they be going home to northern Mexico, or will Los Huertos go back to southern Canada? I have a thesis on the similarities, the wonderful similarities between Canadians and my people. It's pretty great. I'll explain it one day. But we're going to start things off here. Spring it off in, go for the handshake. Cross body, he's not falling for it. Whereas the Dungeon Brothers sometimes show that sportsmanship. Los Huertos is not going to fall for it that easily. Nice crucifix there. Putting him down into the corner. There's a lockup. There's the Calgary Stallion. Getting those shots in the midsection. Ring again. Another crossbody. That's how you do it, baby. You get familiar with those ropes. And just a straight sock to the face. On Mason. Austin now going for a kick inside the thigh. There's a lockup. Shoots off with a short arm. Back elbow. Nicely done. Tagging out of the fresh man. To get his licks in. Smashing the heads together to prove that he has a stronger mind. Drops that leg across the throat, but he gets a toe tap to the temple. Well, actually the forehead. Shoots in, big wheel deflected. Another cross body. That's how he does it, baby. One count only. So you're not going to get much of that. It definitely caught him by surprise, though. You got to admire just taking the opportunity. Sometimes the element of surprise can be in your favor, like that heel kick caught him right in the mush. How you doing, Godzilla's Man Cave? That's a freaking awesome name. That's a really cool name. Oh, and a face crusher. Already living up to its name. Busting open one half of Los Huertos. Putting a little red on that face paint. I'm just completely in awe of your name. It rocks. All right, Mason now tagging back into Austin. Picking him up. Capture. Setting him back to outside, but he is in the wrong hood. Fisherman's Buster, nicely done. Oh, heck yeah. Nice leg drop there. Love some Fire Pro simulation matches. My buddy Ginger Pimpernel does that, as well as Andrew Everett, the big dog over at Andy E. Plays, twitch.tv. I'm broadcasting tonight as a special broadcast. Usually do that over on his channel with Fire Pro World. For W3, Whole World Wrestling. It's a weekly variety show with backstage promos, in-ring segments, everything. We got some really good stuff lined up there. A lot of gears moving for that machine. So if you haven't already, be sure to check out that channel. It should be up and running tomorrow. There is a storm in their location, so figured I'd do something to, for anybody who was looking to be entertained tonight. I'll do my very best. And speaking of which, being entertained here, he's got him locked in. He's still a little fresh here. The count is being administered, but he is looking at those ropes. He's a little air hungry. Taking a bite. No! Took a bite of that fist to the face. And now trying to tag in his tag team partner with a more fresher man, but he goes in for the hook of the leg. One count only. Now grabbing the back of his neck like a bad kitty. Oh, smashing his face into the turnbuckle. You don't do that to a kitty, jerk. And now heading up to the top rope as he hangs onto the arm. Double axe handle down onto the arm. Oh, heck yeah, that sounds dope. Oh, missing the double knee, so into the corner. There's a lockup now. Snapmare takeover. And twist into the face. The tag in now. I believe that is Benny coming into the ring. The kick to the midsection there. Knife is shot, not letting him go right then and there. Oh, nice backbreaker. Place, but he kicks right back up, letting him know it doesn't affect him. He's still a little fresh. Go for another one. He's targeting that spine. Oh, Skinner versus Diesel. Dope. I would have watched that when I was a kiddo. Good times. And now firing away into the corner. Short arm clothesline. And taking it out. The tag team partner with him in a springboard DDT to the floor, but not before placing his head on the apron. Hardway style. It's one of the hardest parts of the ring. Charges in. Crucifix. I thought for sure he would have tried to hold the pin on that one. But he gets him right back up. How you doing, Cameron? Swinging neck breaker there. By the Calgary Stallion, Mason. shoves him off. Ducks it, turns around. Picking him up for a big scoop slam into the corner. He landed on those ropes a little awkwardly. That definitely could tweak the back just a little bit into your favor. And now, speaking of which, there, speaking of tweaking the back, pile driver with a textbook execution by the Calgary Stallion. One, two, almost a quick, well, not quick, but a pretty easy, well, not easy, well, you know, just a sudden successful defense. Dears Gibson, gravy on that Larry. And now, looks like he's setting up for a little dive action. Here we come, Felicita through the, in between the ropes, landing all that weight right on top of the head of one half of Los Muertos. And the referee administering that 10 count. We don't want to end this on a double draw. We want to see a definite winner. Nice hip throw there with a reversal of the punch. How you doing, Hecht? It's a kick to the midsection now. Hey, number nine. Good to see you. Fisherman's Plex on the floor. Head scissors takeover and landing him into those the apron a little awkwardly. Is that the seven? They better get back inside. And fighting away with that powerbomb. It looks like he could be going for the pole on that one. Scoop and a float over. Kick to the knee. The leg out of the leg. Oh no. Snap suplex nine. They better get back inside. No. Just in the nick of time. Oh my gosh. You got to hand it to the referee for giving just a little bit of extra time on that one. But now getting caught up with triple acquaintances. There it is, the three suplexes, but he's right back up, though. That's adrenaline kicking in. Wait a minute, Cody Gonzalez, special animal face buster. A gory bomb. Hooks that leg, we could have new tag team champions, but no. It certainly does, Godzilla Van Cave. This is the batshit bonanza. A sort of a birthday extravaganza that I put together. My birthday was yesterday. So I decided to do it today as a nice little placeholder for, you'll find on this channel, Godzilla, that I name things very, very eccentrically. Speaking of eccentrically, thank you so much for the belated. You too, number nine. Thank you so much. Big clothesline, almost taking his head clean off there. And he's definitely feeling the energy of it. They're getting closer and closer to those campeonatos de parejas. Gorgeous load of a suplex there. Northern Lights, if you will. Picking him right back up, though. He's got to stay on top of him. And there he is, placing him in between the knees. Pile driver. That could very well be it. Oh, no worries, Hex. Thank you. Now the Calgary Stallion back inside. Drops that like, oh, man, that was a thud. Let me tell you. Working his way back up to his feet. There was a little assistance with a front face lock. Now dragging him closer to his corner, but he's fighting off. He knows that he's going into a danger zone. Dropkick finds its mark right on the chin of Stallion. Tagging now to the fresher man. That's Benny. Gets caught though. Wait a minute. Calgary Stallion trying to go for the Blackheart driver, but he reverses into a tombstone. And now charging. Oh, he meant the knee on that one. Usually they get their cheap shots in. But he was waiting. Wait a minute, a suicida! And the Calgary Stallion charging to assist his tag team partner. Oh, wait a minute right here. He's got him in that powerbomb positioning. Under the apron. And he's, oh, smacking his head right into the pole. T-Bone against the apron. Straight up punishing the spine and back region. At the seven, he wants to get back in. He's ready to go. Oh, deflects that kick. Catches him though, he's trying to go for another drop kick on that. The jaw jack kick to the midsection, deflecting again, spins it around. Forearm smash, dazing him. Was able to go behind. Reverse DDT, slip drop. Now propping him right back up. He's got him on the wobblies. Dragging him closer to his corner, probably to tag in his partner. There it is. Double team maneuver coming in. Rocket launcher! Gorgeous crossbody! And that could set him up for the killing blow. Places him. There it is. The signature maneuver that they both share. Blackheart driver! Goes for the cover! One! One count only. That's in. Hurricanrana. No, rolls into an arm drag. Nicely done. Oh, deflects that kick. They got him scouted. Punching the sweat and face paint off the cheek. Drop down. Leapfrog. Big wheel kick. And he's crawling. Bridget gets the tag. That's in. Nice prop up. Drop kick. And it shoots him off into the ropes. Drops him down with a high flapjack. There's that boxing background. Snapmare takeover. Face twist, trying to bust open the skin. Looks in. Gordy Gardano special bomb. Hooks that leg. What? No, not even a one. So usually this is where the tag team partner comes in to run defense, but that is not the case. He's definitely taking some punishment on this one. Cracks an egg over his skull. Drop kick down to the floor goes Stallion. And the Swords in. They're not letting. I'll tell you, they are not short of any springs in their steps. And Los Huercos can taste the gold within the grasp. Soul butt. Unloading those shots on him with a go behind. Oh, I think he's going to go for a poison rana, but instead, oh, it's straight up Frankensteiner. They're at the seven. They better get out of that corner. Neck breaker, eight. Tag in. They better get back inside. And they got the count. He's been busted open. But he beat him up way too badly. The titles do not change hands via countout. Los Huercos getting the countout victory, but they do not have those tag team championships. How you doing, John? And look at this beautiful form right here. Crossbody landed him. I don't know why they're celebrating. Unfortunately, the titles cannot change hands through countout. So therefore, still your Campeonatos de Parejas, the Dungeon Brothers. Now, hopefully Los Huercos can grasp the standard rules of the tag team competition someday. But, you know, that's neither here nor there. Alrighty, let's go ahead here. Ooh, okay. So we're going to see a couple of Monster versus Minis matches here. Well, not technically Minis, but we shall see. Yeah, maybe they're just sending a message. That's true. They could be sending a message. Although, what better message would it be if they had won the tag team gold? I don't know. I'm weird like that. I'm old school, you know. It's fine. We are going to see a title defense of the UWF Championship. And we will see the challenger, your favorite and mine, Giuseppe Gus Marino, is going to be taking on, or excuse me, this is actually for oh boy. The International Heavyweight Championship held by Yokozuna. Giuseppe, as always, has his work cut out for him. Ha ha ha.
And let's go ahead. Hi, Chainsaw. The International Heavyweight Wrestling Championship. Introducing first the challenger. Thank you, Chainsaw.
Trova una scusa per uscire di casa. Fatti mandare dalla mamma a prendere il latte. Devo dirti qualche cosa che riguarda noi due.
Gianni Morandi.
T'ho visto uscire dalla scuola.
Always great to hear over the PA speakers. Opponent. Coming through the balloon arch in such a menacing fashion. The International Heavyweight Champion, Yokozuna. Lamps. True. Hi, MSK. Thank you. And that prestigious international championship will be taken off the gigantic shoulder of Yokozuna and placed on the line as Giuseppe Gus Marino, the eternal light heavyweight champion. Doing okay, Chainsaw. Just decided to do this quick emergency broadcast to hold everyone over just a little bit until we can get things rolling next time for the rescheduled broadcast of W3. Yokozuna ready to defend. Yep, that's how you do it. He looked like he's fumbling the title just a little bit. This is some relaxing-ass music, let me tell you. All right, there you have it. The International Heavyweight Championship on the line. Buffalo, New York zone. Giuseppe Gus Marino, ready to go. People booing Yokozuna. The international champion. Definitely not making too many friends here with his intimidating presence. I think he's just misunderstood, honestly. As a referee, showing off the prize of this matchup, the International Heavyweight Championship. Let's do this. Giuseppe Gasparino versus Yokozuna. Yeah, Yokozumbas are always great. And now charging in, knocking down Giuseppe. Oh, he got him at the stomp, though. Usually Giuseppe is pretty fast to get out of the way. Oh, that's a lot of weight coming down on that shoulder. Now, mind you, oh, okay, the heart punch definitely making me sweat just a little here. He is pounding that man's chest like Leland Palmer. Whoa, pops him up with the greatest of ease. No way. No way is this it. One count only as Giuseppe Gasparino fights on. Oh, God. You hear the thud, the slap of that meaty thigh against the entire head of Gus Marino. And now picking him up for a bear hug, trying to get the easy victory here, but I do not think. There we go. Giuseppe fighting with every bit of strength in his heart. Watch in. Head and scissors takeover. Nicely done. Of course, Giuseppe Gasparino, a well-known junior, or light heavyweight, if you will, has been known to take on so many giants and stand tall in the face of adversity. But he gets rolled off again. Down to the floor he goes. Oh, what the hell is this? Yokozuna chomping him down, but he missed. I think his ankles might have blown out. Picking up Gus now. Throwing him hip first onto that apron as he slides down. And now getting thrown back inside. Yokozuna definitely wanting this to be an official victory. And letting the fans get their boos in. As Giuseppe now catching that headbutt. That is a high angle on that knee drop Yokozuna just did. As Giuseppe now trying to get backed up to his feet. Oh boy, Saito suplex! He's right back up though! Shoots him off into the ropes! Big gut check! That might have been a little low, but I'm not going to say anything. And now pulling on the nose cartilage of Yokozuna, digging the fingers into the eyes as well. Giuseppe using those old shooter tactics against the big man from Japan, the current defending international heavyweight champion, Yokozuna. But Yokozuna still having some strength in those stems. It's a kick right to the head, though. Oh, with a float over by Giuseppe, wraps the arm around, slick drop, reverse DDT. Driving that bear knee, that's a lot of bone. There's no cartilage, folks. He mainly keeps the knee pads there to make sure that it doesn't hurt entirely. I think it's used to keep the knees up into the form that they are. Exactly. Happy belated birthday to my brother Slip from New Legacy. His birthday on September 10th. Up next, I believe, is my brother Jericho from New Legacy, Inc. His birthday's coming up in a couple of weeks. And now picking him up there, Fireman's Carry. Where is he taking Giuseppe Gasparino? Dropping him down on the top rope. Yokozuna now kicking out the leg, trying to pull. Oh, yeah, Giuseppe going for that grasp. But it's like blood in the water now to a hangry shark. One, two, count two. Yokozuna can't believe what he is seeing here. The heart of this man. Known as Gus Marino. Oh, nice driving of the shoulder there. As he was able to grab a hold of that wrist and spin the arm downward into the inertia. Winds it up. Uppercut. Stunning the international heavyweight champion. Picks out that leg. Slaps it down. And now Gus Marino sees the opportunity. He's going to take it. Whether it's a good idea or not, double exhale. Oh, no. Backbreaker on the floor. Yokozuna saw him coming. And now a neckbreaker. No, a straight-up elbow to the throat. Belly to belly on the floor. Is that the threeve? Shoulder, well, ribs first into there. He tried to go for shoulder block, but Yokozuna just standing tall there. Throwing him down into the apron and says, get out of here. And Giuseppe Gasparino saying, where's my opponent? Where you at? Referee telling Yokozuna to get back inside. Happy you're here, Aiden. Oh, now big release, German suplex there. Not too bad, Aiden. Had a nice dinner with my family. Saw the wonderful wishes. Oh! One, two. What in the world? Are you kidding me? Giuseppe Gasparino. Oh, he got the knees up. He kicked out of that bonsai drop. Not even with the... with the respect of the full execution. Yokozuna just dropping the weight down, and now he's got the champion in the figure four. This could very well be it. Yokozuna is in the figure four leg lock, courtesy of Gus Marino. But now he's turned it over. Oh, his leg is caught in the crack, as you can see. Trying to take the leg. They're both hurting. Oh, big STO. And now just straight up murder attempting on Gus Marino, stomps away at the wrist. Stepping up. Oh, shit. No, 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 no. Oh, a slash to the floor and an elbow drop by Gus Marino. And Yokozuna feeling the effects of the high-risk miss. And Gus Marino capitalizing on it, busting open the champion. Head first into that guardrail. And shooting him back inside. Giuseppe Gus Marino taking his time. Letting the crowd fuel him up. Yokozuna, as you can see, clearly busted open from the hard, callous knuckles of Giuseppe. What in the world? He picked him up with a fireman's carry, but he's fighting out of it. Throat thrust there by the champion. German suplex once again. Yeah, true chainsaw. He could have gone for the count-out victory, but Giuseppe Gus Marino given a golden opportunity here tonight to win the International Heavyweight Championship. But I don't think it's looking too well for him again. Oh, bonsai drop. One, two, three. Oh, my goodness. Yokozuna sweating bullets with blood in the mixture. Let's take a look here at the further punishment. Giuseppe Gus. Oh my god, right here. Whoa! Oh my gosh. As the eternal light heavyweight champion, not international material, Yokozuna showing signs of pure arrogance. Yokozuna say that the International Heavyweight Championship is his and only his. But we love Giuseppe Gus Marino, and we know that he fought valiant and bravely. Man, oh man. Whew, that was a heck of a contest there. Let's go ahead and see what we can find as the music for our next challengers. All right, let's go ahead now. We're going to see a UWF title defense, honestly. Oh, boy. Well, those of you who were around for our annual CAW open invitational known as Tough Nuff, you might have seen this individual very much in his own world. Miles Vandeveer IV. Is going to be taking on the UWF champion and Gunther. Yeah, that dick, Miles Vandeveer IV. No, he's not putting the Tough Nuff title on the line. Gunther putting his UWF championship on the line, though. Yeah, this fucking guy. The following champion versus champion contest is scheduled for one fall. Here we go!
Book up quick at a bar.
Are you fucking kidding me? This jerk is coming out to the Dynamite Hack version of Boys in the Hood? Look at this jerk. I'll blow it out, Dizzle. How you doing, Emerald? Yeah, we are in an exotic location of Des Moines, Iowa. Oh my God. The most douchiest thing ever. That's barely, I don't care. They gotta know where I live first.
It's all about playing that GTA.
Cause the boys
in the hood are always hard. Come talking that trash and we'll pull your car. Knowing nothing in life but to be legit. Don't quote me, boy, I ain't said shit.
He stinks. Oh no, that was the whole joke about Godzilla. This guy's a jerk. And his opponent. Gunther is here. Der Ring General has entered the building. The UWF champion is here. Oh man, that menacing presence, that dominating stance. The man takes his jacket off in complete business. And here we go, that's what it's for, the UWF Heavyweight Championship. I love Gunther. I actually love Walter. So Honky had a good run, honestly. Yeah, I talked over Miles Vanderveer's intro. I don't care. Here we go. Miles Vanderveer is going to die. And Miles Vanderveer very, very confident in his chances here tonight. That's dope, Zebra. Here we go with the money green and gold gear. Claims that his wrist tape and knee pads are made of pure ivory, and already getting shots in on the UWF champion, Gunther. Oh boy. And a headbutt stunning him. Knife edge shot, first one of the matchup. Oh, wiggling the patitas. That's him with a slip drop. All legit, Cameron? Hell yeah. If you can find the tags of that, let me know, or whoever the person that's created it was. Tiger Bomb! There's a boots off. And now Miles Vandiver the IV trying to get those strikes in to hold off and defend against Gunther. And those gigantic heavy hits and chops. And then don't forget the head is also the hardest part of the body. Picks him up. Look at the power display. And Law wisely wiggling out the back but meets an elbow. And a big boot for his trouble. Picking him up now. Fireman's carry. Close to the corner. Face first into the turnbuckles featuring our brand new U62 logo coming soon to the screen display. Kicking him off though, Miles Vandiver really has to. Oh, he missed that clothesline. Back elbow there. You saw him enter this matchup with his Tough Enough championship. Still flying it, proud of his accomplishments. I mean, it is a pretty big deal. Big boot there by Gunther. Pipping him right back up. Sitting down on that shoulder. Turning him around with that potato punch. And now locks in a sleeper hold. Body scissors applied. This could very well be the it for Miles Vandiver the IV. No, he's sliding out of it. Rolls through now. He's got him in a pin. One. One count only. Drop kick to the knee, but that just hit those thighs. Fall dropping down there. Cross face. Oh, God, look at the miserable expression on Miles Vandiver's face. Charging through, but no, not much pull on it. Shoots off into the ropes. Back elbow there by Gunther. Oh, crap. Now heading up to the top. Miles Vandiver better roll out of the ring right now. Right now! Big splash by the champion! One, two, count two. Holy crap. I don't know if it's the pure heart or stupidity of Miles Vandiver, but he kicked out of that big splash somehow and is working over. Oh, what a face buster! He drove Gunther's head right into the canvas. One, two. Oh my God, he got to two. Miles Vandiver the IV was so close with that Vandiver. God, I hate that name. With the Vandiver. Driving Gunther's head into that mat and was nanoseconds away from a three count, crowning himself a UWF heavyweight champion. And exactly, he rocked Gunther and rocked him even more with that strike. Heading up to the top there as he carefully scoots by. What the hell is he going for here? Big knee drop. Covering. Hooks the leg even. One, two. So close. Oh boy, Vandiver's not going to let this up anytime soon. Oh, nice hip throw there by Gunther. Shoot off into the corner. Big boom, busting him open. Vandiver now bleeding. Looks like the corner of his eye. And Gunther with a big heavy kick to the small of the back. Scoops him up. Flotion! Drives that hip! But he's in the ropes. He was in the ropes. Gunther not looking too happy about that referee doing his job. Shoots off. Oh, deflects him! And now Vandiver! Backbreaker! Pulling neckbreaker! And now grabbing a hold of the weapons of Gunther, stomping away, digging the heel into the hands, trying to break one of the formidable weapons in the arsenal of Gunther. And now crossing over the face, trying to bust him open in return. Wait a minute, he sees who's at the entrance. Nothing. He hears someone. Wait a minute! Why is this guy in here? And Vandiver not letting it. I'm not pushing anything, Aiden. Well, that assistance for Gunther. Very short-lived. Giovanni Vici? That's a stupid-ass name. DDT by Vandiver. He has Gunther in a pretty dangerous spot right there. Oh, Oh, this is the double stump. Gunther now, trying to capitalize on it, but Vandeveer with a Vandeveer. He better hurry. Hooks that leg. 1, 2. Holy crap! Miles Vandeveer IV is the UWF champion. No way! Play my damn music. No, we're not gonna play it again. Play my damn music or I'll sue you. Son of a bitch. Hey, come on. Don't shove the ref. Oh, damn it. Miles Vandeveer now the Tough Enough champion and the newly crowned UWF heavyweight champion. Go to hell, Aiden. Hey, Everall. I had a pretty good birthday. Thank you so much for asking. Up in the budget. No! No more fireworks! We're gonna get in trouble! Get out of here! All right. Let's see here. Oh, you found the 91? Cool. What I did for my birthday? I had a wonderful dinner with my mom and dad. And then I just chilled most of the day. Oh, Grits. Well, funny you should ask. Funny you should mention Grits, because we got ourselves a little ditty of a ditty. And by that, I mean a 2 out of 3 tables match. Got to do it for singles. That's right, a TO3T match. Not at Hell in a Cell, though. At the batshit bonanza. That's what this is, folks. This is batshit. We are going to see. Grits Gumbo set to take on War Bacon. Let's get this going. This is a fun match here. I've been waiting for this to happen for a while, baby. Ever since it was announced that War Bacon was to come back. Here we go, folks. Oh, these names are fantastic, Godzilla. Here we go! Gumbo, ready to lash out some Cajun-style swamp-ass beating. Not like beating a swamp-ass, but just beating your ass like a swamp. And his opponent... Thank you.
War Bacon, freshly back. I believe this is his third match after Sword Lord Beef Sons of Bitch Championship. I mean, we might make a beefy boy division, so...
As I stated there, this is War Bacon's third match back after losing his spot in the elimination tournament by the numerical rules. But hey, it was like three other people against him. Things have definitely evolved since his time earlier in the years of WFWF. Nice knee to the midsection there by War Bacon as he tried to get in with that fireman's, or excuse me, the fallway slam on a Grits combo, but Grits now firing away. Sliding to the outside, already setting up the table for supper time. Oh yeah, Everall, fucking Nappy Roots rules. Yeah, Grits is huge, man. Shoots off, throwing him over the top there. Oh, trying to go for a shoulder check, but look at that one. War Bacon knew that he was coming. Grits trying to swing away with a Larry. Shot to the kidneys now, shoots off into the ropes. Pops him up, over the shoulder, power slam! If you've forgotten how strong War Bacon is, there's a reminder. If you've forgotten how fast and agile Grits Gumbo is, there's a reminder. Where's a lot of these gentlemen? Football backgrounds, or just straight up farm work, or gator wrestling. Yeah, legit. Athletic Commission, really heavy this year. We got a multiple... Territory, what the hell? Spin him around. Look at that boy there, they go with a spin. Oh! That's one right there. Grits Gumbo got the first table break with that piggly wiggly power slam, baby. Whoa, look at that distance. That was nuts. Now ribs first into that guardrail. I said before, we got a multi-regional international deal for the Netwood. They made him wear the shoes. Punching down on him. Deflects. And now Grits looking to make a second victory of this one. Yeah, War Bacon officially awoken. Look at the strength of Big Grits Gumbo! Suplay! And setting up again. Oh man, War Bacon. War Bacon has not been on the best of streaks right now. Oh no! Back body drop! But that's gonna make you go crazy. Ow! No! Hell no! Picking him up, T-bone suplex into the rubble. Thank you, Draco. Love you too, buddy. And Grits, the master of the brawl style there, every match that he's had, especially against Silo, one of his main enemies. They have taken it everywhere. Ah! Twice and back. So many bloody brawls. So much carnage. Oh! Big crossbody by War Bacon sandwiching Grits into that guardrail. Oh, you remember this in 2 days, Star? Awesome! Okay, I'll try to remember that. And a stair fight! Grits winning it, though! Ah, yes, Grits and Silo. Fantastic and hellish feud. Luckily, the ankle of War Bacon knocking down that setup table. It was not looking good for him as Grits coming back in. Big drop kick there to the temple. And cracking his face with that table frame. Yeah, those fuckers hated each other. And now War Bacon, he could very well turn the... I don't want to say it. He's turning the tides. Oh, thank goodness. Against Grits Gumbo. I almost said with an element of the stipulation. I hate doing that. And now, oh, he's going to go for a Bama Slamma into the corner. Oh, watch your ankles for Bacon. Oh, no. Grixton Blow. Oh, slamming him down, getting him in the ropes. I think that might have been just pure excitement there, stunning him even more. And now, oh, shit, placing those ham hocks right onto the table. Grixton Blow. They got him. Man, War Bacon, you got to do some serious tape watching, brother. Grixton Blow, look at this. Fire out the gate, slamming him down. And then right here shortly after, War Bacon put through that table. And Grits Gumbo able to get the victory here tonight. How you doing, Doinkus? All right. Let's see what else we got here. Oh, I know. Let's do a three-way dance. Actually, no, let's do a triple threat. Let's do a triple threat. First one to a fall is the winner. Triple threat. At the batshit bonanza. Bananers. It's all right if I pick a little ripe banana. I like when they're soft and brown or when they're hard and green. Let's me here as we see. Jack Ederton. Gunnar Hansen. Jack Ederton. Set to take on Super Rad. Let's do the purple. Versus. Oh, we saw Powder Kick last time. We still got some debuts to do later on. You know what? Lance Maverick. Bonanas for Bonanza. That's cool. We're just doing a little fun here. Oh, the Fucked Fuckers division has a championship chainsaw. We will be putting a little more focus on that in the next broadcast. Believe you me. Yeah, I know. Here we go. The man of the Intercontinental Territories. Also a world tag team champion with his brother James Ederton. This is a better song. I fucking hate What It's Like by Everlast because it reminds me of all the times I had to wake up from wonderful dreams in middle school. Double Continental Champion. These are all giant belt buckles he wears on his jeans. For when he goes shopping on Rodeo Drive. And his opponent. Jason, thank you. Thank you for the donation of $20. Definitely the more calmer-tempered Super Rad, as opposed to his tag team partner, Super Rad Dose, with a blood feud against Slice of Slice and Dice. They have yet to come to a halt. Here we go, folks. Their opponent! I appreciate that, Chainsaw. It's true. The U62 World Television Weight Champion. Now, Godzilla, if you're not familiar, the stipulation for the television weight champion is you have to weigh equal or more the amount of a classic big screen television. That's how you qualify for this division. Oh, absolutely, Aiden. Raccoon Raid, thank you for the raid! Thank you so much for the raid! Here we go, Jack Edgerton versus Super Rad versus Lance Maverick. Triple threat match, trying to go for that big drop kick there by Jack Edgerton. Look at the size difference. Nice crawl right there by the U62 television weight champion. Those of you unfamiliar what a television weight is, you have to weigh equal or more the amount of a classic big screen television. And those things were boulders, let me tell you. Jack Edgerton now, double continental champion, gets a flying clothesline courtesy of Super Rad. Lance Maverick now trying to pull the Achilles. That hyperextension. Nice neck breaker there by the Orange County crime fighter known as Super Rad. Back elbow deflected. So happy you're here, Raider. Thank you so much. Mwah. Nice face buster there by Jack Edgerton. Working over the arm, though. Trying to go for the body of Lance Maverick is in the way of their confrontation. Back elbow, crossbody, nobody there. Yeah, everyone, you were right. You were right. Maverick definitely belongs in our brand new division of the fucked fuckers. No need to hammer it, Everall. It's an Aquabat song. And now a chair being brought in. I mean, the weapons are legal. Picks him up. Nice high angle hip toss. Fighting off Big Jack Edgerton. Super Rad now. Oh, got caught. Nice hip throw. Thank you, Jay. Picking him up now. Pump handle. No! Reverse it into a floss body. Flying clothesline. And now, wait a minute. Melvin Driver! Hooks it, one, two, no. If you ever made it a United States Championship, what it would be? We actually did, what was it? Oh, we did a European Intercontinental Championship called Eurocont. And we have a United States Heavyweight Championship. We just haven't really done anything with it yet. But I was thinking the stipulation of it is that if you can scarf down an entire bucket of queso-covered hot dogs in under an hour, you qualify for that particular division. And now Lance Maverick getting the chair out of the grasp of Super Rad.
Ah, Deshaun, thank you so much for the community sub. 10 community sub gifts. I appreciate you. Mwah. And again, Raccoon Queen, mwah, thank you so much for the raid. I appreciate that. Thank you all so much. Godzilla, thank you for the follow, as well as Project Rico yesterday.
Nice slam there by Super Rad. Big drop kick by Jack Edgerton. Wind up with that taped fist. There's a kick to the head there by Super Red. Lance Maverick collecting himself or trying to come down off of whatever he took before this matchup. And speaking of taking something, Jack Edgerton with a chair shot to the face courtesy of Super Red. Forearm smash now, shooting him off into the ropes. Kitchen sink of the Lance Maverick shoots in, trying to pick out Super Red next. But Super Red picking him up! Head in between the cheeks with that pile driver. That was a very particular angle. And now Lance Maverick, big boy Santon, slipped in the big boy. Sound like Danzig meets Hank Hill on that one. Slipped her the big one. Whoa.
Let's see here. New activity. Hey, Everall with the 20 bits. Thank you so much.
Now big scoop and a slam. Big knee to the back there by Super Red. Rolling him down. Google Drive link, wink, wink. Ping, oh, Edgerton's been busted open. And I'm surprised Maverick has definitely not been busted open. Whoa, almost a complete annihilation by them. Ah, gotcha, Aiden, gotcha. The turnaround now. Scoop it. Oh, Maverick's heels caught the apron on the way down. That is an awkward landing, let me tell you. Northern Lights flex there by Maverick. Ducks that chop, though, by Edgerton, who picks him up and slams him down on that steel chair. Oh, that pissed him off. Side rushing leg sweep onto the floor. There's no countouts. They're still brawling and falling everywhere. Oh, the son of Super Rat hitting the floor. Big wheel! Slipped him the big wheel. And now Maverick shooting off. Super Rat back into the ring. He's going a little fancy footwork with his microphone moves as he gets thrown back in courtesy of Jack Edgerton. Lock up now, breakthrough. Oh, soul butt there by Maverick. Big wheel catches Edgerton on the side. And now what is Maverick going to go for here? Oh, I think he's going to go for that rolling lariat. Oh, back bunny drop.
Oh!
And the groupies go crazy. One, two, count two. Super Rat, I thought he was going to go in with that chair, but is he looking for something else? I guess not. Coming back inside. Oh, kitchen sink. Oh, lifting knee. But a flying clothesline catches him. Jack Edgerton appreciating the help and using it to his advantage with a swinging neck breaker onto Super Rad. Drop kick. Those are some big boots to the side of your boogie. Oh, he got caught. So, whoa. What the hell? Super Rad trying to go for that strong arm toss. But Jack Edgerton busting some season 3 arrow shit with that spinning footland. And look at the blood pouring down the face of Jack Edgerton. Oh, down goes Super Red. He is punishing the superhero. Nice pull, slip back. Almost landing on that chair. And wait a minute, Lance Maverick now heading up to the top. Telling Edgerton to get back onto his feet. Could be going for that stage dive. Cross it in. Stage dive. Bouncing up on that chair. Hooks the leg. One, two. No. Super Rad breaks the count. Turns him around. Shoots off into the corner. Monkey flip. On top. Oh, I thought it was going to land on top of Edgerton. That was close. Arm wringer. Nice self-defense roll. Slaps the leg out courtesy of almost the Hellblazer. or Hellwalker, whoever the hell that character was. Jack Enterton now. Pile driver squashing the head of Super Rad. One, two, no! Big close eye to the corner, rolling him down to the floor. He's saying that could be it. That big Larry, one, two, count two. Crucifix, I tried to go for a pin. I thought for sure that would have been all. Neck breaker on the Maverick. If Super Rad can get up for that Mike Cerruto special, he could very well get the victory here tonight. Try to go for that cannonball. How you doing, Tizzle? Key on by Jack Enterton. Super Rad now. Oh, shit. With the greatest of ease. Throws him off. Swings him around. With a slam. Maverick says, I'm still here. Whoa, look at the power! Well, it's not for the title, Jay. It's just for fun, an exhibition triple threat. Nice slick back there. Shot to the guts by Enterton. Turns him around. Tiger suplex. Now Super Rad trying to go for the kendo shot, but Enterton just too fast. Crossbody splash. Oh, he should have went for the pin on that one. And now heading up to the top rope. Can we go for the Mike Cerruto special? Kendo shot to the thighs by Lance Maverick. Drop kick, man, that took his soul out of his body. And now Super Rat picking up Big Jack Enterton. Dropping him down on that turnbuckle. Here at the Batshit Bonanza, we got a lot going on here. Kicking, boot to the midsection. Everall, thanks so much for the 1 month here. And everybody just colliding in the center. Super Rad. Oh, trying to go for something, but Enterton caught him. These guys are tired. Enterton now unloading those tape fists. Ah, Maverick getting caught into the action. Back elbow there on the Super Rad. Scoop and a slam into the turnbuckles. High knee. Oh, that caught him in the chin. And now picking him up. Beamer slam onto those ropes. But he rolls up Enterton to this pulse package. One, two, three. Ah, man. Maverick got him. Let's play the music again. I love the music. Watch right here. The Melvin's driver. Right, the Bama Slamma, right into those ropes. We thought for sure that would have been all, but right there, Maverick pulled the tuck job and caught Enterton with a three count. Man, this wasn't even for the championship. But Lance Maverick slipping him the big one. All right, let's go ahead and make our way now to the semi-main event of this broadcast. It's going to be a special one here because we are going to crown the inaugural seasonal champion, the first champion of this season for WFWF U62 in association with Coastal Territory Championship Wrestling, Big Dog Territory, and Whole World Wrestling. Here at the Batshit Bonanza, could I steal your idea for the Eurocont title and make the Harry Colon Memorial Heavyweight title? Go ahead, Dar. Go for it. Yes, we will be debuting the United States Weight Championship very soon. And again, the only way to qualify for that belt is you have to heat an entire bucket full of queso-covered glizzies. So, bun and all. Exactly, Jay Sean. That was kind of the look I was going to go for, like a Stevie Richards meets like a Scotty the Body, Scotty Flamingo kind of thing. So combining both elements of the old Raven's Nest / Flock. Here we go. Thunderdome Deathmatch. So this is came up with this before the whole lockdown situation. But this whole thing is it's a knockout only elimination chamber. The only way to get eliminated is if you get your ass knocked out. And it is for the WWF U62 Women's Championship. All right, everyone, thanks for stopping by. Thank you for all the wonderful bits and the subscriptions. Thank you so much. You have a good night, okay? But yep, here we go. Our participants are the current Tough Nuff champion, Rei Kobayashi. We will not have entrances. That is way too much fucking music. from W3 territory, Akane Komodo. We will also have a previous season Tough Nuff competitor. I fucked up. Orboro Daigo. Let's do the other. I like her original gear. There we go. And then we will have former Tough Nuff competitor as well and champion, Suzume Amari. Along with newcomer from the outside turf, Terry Bush. And finally, also from W3 territory, a former champion of multiple divisions in her own right. I'm, of course, referring to... Where did she go? There we go, Black Widow. The U62 Women's Championship on the line. These six competitors have to knock each other out until one is left remaining. Who will walk out the inaugural U62 champion of the women's division in WFWF? Here we go. Arboro Daigo and Rei Kobayashi starting off there. Arboro with a spear right into the midsection there. Rei Kobayashi woke it up out of that one. She was ready to go, but that caught her by surprise. She goes in for a snapmare takeover. Drop kick to the side of the head. Now heading up to the top. Elbow drop, finding its mark. Mind you, folks, any move, they got to hit their hardest. Any move can take you out of this match. She's working over the arms of Arboro Daigo. This young upstart impressing everybody with her wonderful victory. Also in a multiple eliminator match for the Tough Nuff secondary division. Nice cravat suplex into the corner. Let's see who's going to be the next combatant to enter. Terry Bush has entered the conversation. Of course, Terry Bush from the classic grappling of the Platinum Blonde Academy, run by one of the hardest hitting grapplers to ever come out of the sport of the old territory days and the traveling days. Nice flying elbow shot. Double kick to the midsection now. Rei Adobo. Double DDT onto Terry Bush. And now right back to Saul. Oh, nice slamming down there with a choke bomb. Baldo, if you will. It's a kick to the hinder. Forearm shot there by Terry Bush. Shoots off over the top. Oh, and now a chop block sideways onto the knee. Nice amateur style slam by Rei Kobayashi. She better not taunt Terry Bush too much. Oh, slap at the back of the head. Disrespect. As the countdown commences, who is the next one in? I believe that is Black Widow from W3. One of the most dangerous competitors in this contest. She is crazy. She will jump off of anything. She will put her body on the line if it means that she gets the gold and the cash. Nice German suplex there. Please stick around for our main event after this. Double noggin knocker by Rei Kobayashi. Triple kicks. Nice big boot to the face by Terry Bush. Dropping her down. The countdown commences once again. We still have yet to see anybody eliminated, but we got two more competitors to come in. Here we got Akane Komodo, also from W3 territory. Whole World Wrestling, if you're not familiar, if you're here and you're not familiar with W3, please be sure to follow twitch.tv/AndyEPlays for the Fire Pro Simulated Show, variety show. Oh, nice inside Fisherman's Buster. Now wiggling in, drives her down, but still in the fight. Could very well choke out Daigo as Rei Kobayashi. And now driving the knee there of Akane Komodo as Black Widow going to work. Roboto Daigo hitting those potatoes into the face as the final countdown commences until we see Suzume Amari, one who does pretty good at this. Nice suplex into the ropes. Exactly. Thank you, Dar. Twitch.tv/AndyEPlays for Whole World Wrestling. W3 action. The Fire Pro World Wrestling Simulated Show. Nice axe kick there by Terry Bush. Said show of W3 featuring backstage antics and promos. And some hard-hitting, incredibly memorable matches with a roster full of colorful and dark colorful characters. Side Russian leg sweep there by Terry Bush. You see Roboto Daigo fighting off both Akane Komodo and Black Widow, and now Terry Bush going over the punches on the head of Rei Kobayashi. Elbow shots there by Rei into the gullet. Polish hammer to the back of the head, courtesy of Akane Komodo. Spinning kick there. It's Terry Bush taking down Suzume. Now working over the kicks into the ribs. Look at the outside. Oh, face buster by Roboto Daigo. And now Akane trying to go for the brain buster. But look at that one. Big clothesline. Face first into the buckles goes Suzume. There's a turnaround. It's Terry Bush now. Knees with kicks. Spinning back elbows. Sliding knee. And I think Rei Kobayashi might be in some serious trouble. Nice drop kick there by Black Widow and Akane Komodo. Big burning Larry by Roboto Daigo. Everything's a cluster. Roboto Daigo driving down Suzume's head into the center of that ring. Oh my god, Rei Kobayashi trying to go for her finishing maneuver, but Roboto Daigo having different ideas and dropping Terry Bush high or low angled, I should say, as her back is not supposed to bend that way. A float over suplex there by Akane. Suzume finally coming back inside, running into Gary, Inzaguri. Under the side of the head of Terry Bush. Terry Bush now burning Larry. Harriet. And now walls of brass. Roboto Daigo is the first eliminated. Locking horns now with Terry Bush. Beautiful capture with the body scissors. into the arm, a triangle choke. Snap suplex there. My Komodo on the Black Widow. Complete annihilation by Suzume and Rey. Wouldn't be a bad tag team, honestly. Fisherman's Buster! Rey Kobayashi is the second eliminated courtesy of Akane Komodo. And now trying to pop the arm out of the socket. Nice flipping run under by Suzume on the Black Widow. And it's down to these four. Soul butt to the midsection. High angle kick. Locking horns now, shooting off over the top. Black Widow trying to get the kick pump on the Terry Bush, but Terry Bush knows better. Grabs a hold of the wrist. Rips the knee right into the mouth. I heard the smack of the teeth on that one. Face buster. Suzume with a big boot, but she might have bumped her head on that one. With the turnaround by Akane. Fujiwara armbar. High angle kick. Black Widow is out. Jaw jack onto Suzume. Oh, nice knee capture by Akane Komodo. But a dragon screw whip capture by Terry Bush. There's a turnaround. Hits that knee strike, only on the back. Not enough to take out Komodo. As Suzume stumbling back up to her feet. Hurricanrana nicely done. Shot to the midsection by Komodo. Breaks free, soul butt break free. Now Bush sending her off into the corner. Knee lift. Kitchen sink, short arm style. High kicks. Working over. Backbreaker. And now scraping the boots across the face of Suzume Amari running through. Big boot. Oh, placing those heavy heels into the kidney area of Suzume Amari, and now with the hammerlock. Oh god, joint manipulation on this one. Drives the knees into the small of the back, rolling through, meeting Komodo. Gut check, nice hip throw, and she stomps over Terry Bush, but gets caught in with an arm drag into the corner. Knife edge chop by Suzume, unleashing the fury. Big boot to the face. Terry Bush now. Charging through. Misses that kick. DDT. But kicks right back up. Big boot to the face on Suzume. And just making light of her opponents. Using these simple calisthenics of getting in and out of the ring. Komodo saw her coming, though. Dropping her down. Picks up. Lotion! Komodo eliminates Terry Bush and now Suzume. Reverse suplex. Heading up to the top now. Could be going for that pulling neck breaker. This one, her tough enough contract. Drop kick to the face. Standing moonsault. There it is. Suzume Amari feeling the effects of the energy in the air. DDT. She knows that eventually Komodo's going to have to go night-night as she runs across the ring. No, it's met with a back elbow. Back suplex there by Komodo. Thought she was going to go for that flosion once more. Kicks off Suzume. Now picking it right back up into a dragon sleeper. That's, oh God, rearing back. This could very well be the end if she taps out or just simply passes out. Snaps to, oh, and a kick bump. Throws Komodo back on the inside. Lock horns, kick to the midsection by Komodo. Unleashing that combination once more. Whip throw. Oh, and like a graceful swan heading up to the top. Big splash. Whoa. Did you see a rotation? A nice kick to the head. Standing himself. There it is. DDT. Low impact, but still painful. Rolls through. Sliding knee to the chest. Heads up now over the top. It's in Frankensteiner. And now they're fighting for the final blow on here. Back suplex onto the floor. Throws her back on the inside, almost clearing that top rope. As Suzume Amari. Now getting a hold, throwing Komodo into the corner. Stomps away at the arm now, heading up to the top rope. She could be going for it. Yep, she's got her sights pointed on Komodo. Pulling neckbreaker. No, no, no. And I thought for sure that that was going to be the end of this contest. Both of these individuals want to be the inaugural U62 Women's Champion. And pulling the hair. Look at the smile. The sick, sadistic smile. She tapped out. Stomping on her ears. Pulling away with the hair. Akane Komodo with that sadistic grin. Right here. Bam. Took out Rei Kobayashi. Right here, grabs a hold of the wrist, steps on both ears, and starts pulling. Here is your winner, Women's Champion, Akane Komodo. And Akane Komodo, showing her own form of sportspersonship, sportsmanship, whatever. She's a jerk. But she is the U62 Women's Champion, the inaugural champion for this season. Nobody can take that away from her. Well, unless they defeat her, but... There you see the view from the chains. Which is a shame, because I think we made a really nice belt. All right, my darlings, let's go ahead and move on to the main event of this broadcast here at the Batshit Bonanza. Yeah, the purple belt does look great with your gear, Doink. Well, we're going to see. A steel cage match. Set for one fall, and it is for the Coastal Territory Heavyweight Championship, but also That's right. Two belts. Two belts. Let's see. For Major Tom Falk, nope. Table Saw Tommy will take on the Coastal Territory, the Missouri champion, mind you, will take on the Coastal Territory heavyweight champion, Cactus Jack. Exactly. Will Cactus Jack be able to pull off a victory against the Missouri heavyweight champion Tom Falk, Major Tom Falk, with a double arm DDT? Oh, they both went for the elbow there. Major Tom, table saw Tommy Falk, got the elbow point, but Cactus now with a hip toss. If he hits that spinning Tom hold on the knees, the already bad knees of Cactus Jack, we could see a double gold hold in table saw. Either way, two belts on the line. These rough and tough as nails individuals squaring up in a steel cage 15 foot high. Scrap trap. I love NWO World Tour. That's a great game. Jay Sean, please tell me you played Virtual Pro 64. The Japanese import, or the original version of World Tour. Major Tom now with a knee to the midsection by Cactus Jack. Yeah, that's a lot of pants. Nice hip throw there by the Coastal Territory heavyweight champion Cactus Jack. Picks him up. Snap suplex. Nice kick to the head there by the challenger and Major Tom. But Jack fires back now. Arm wringer. Gut check. Headbutt. Cactus heading up to the top of the scrap trap. Drops the knee right across the heart. Let's see if that's enough. Oh, close to two, but not a three. Jaw jack there by Major Tom. Shoots in from behind. Sleeper hold. No, pulls him back with a slick back onto Cactus. Now trying to open up the wounds, the scars on the face of Cactus. Slamming his head down as you hear the thud of it on that mat echoing on those heavy wooden boards. And now a DDT for his trouble. Back break now. Oh yeah, absolutely, Jay. Virtual Pro 64 is basically just the same as WCW NWO World Tour for Nintendo 64, but it was a Japanese game originally. One of the largest rosters for the AKI games. It's pretty great. Cactus now, swinging neck breaker as he unloads those fists onto the face, but now Major Tom firing back with some of his own! With a neck breaker to follow! Who did it better? Who do you like more that did it better? Now cracking an egg over his skull. Shot to the belt buckle there by Cactus. Now launching Major Tom into the corner. Kick to the gut by Cactus now, getting a small running charge. Knee to the face. And now Cactus looking to slap on that double arm DDT. All the way for truth or consequence. No, he's got that stump puller pile driver. One, two, no! Major Tom escapes. Cactus is in disbelief. And the fans wanting him to fight forever. Oh, that knee is not going to have a good day tomorrow. The kick to the top of the head now. Major Tom whipping him off into the ropes. trying to drop kick the lower area. And now Cactus reliving some memories from that hard, stiff headbutt that he just gave Major Tommy. Trying to go for another one, but no luck on that one. Flop kick to the knee, down he goes. Major Tom now picking him right back up. Kick to the midsection. Lifts him up. Patella! Brain buster! One, two, what a whoa! I spin around my Cactus to hear the Kane Dewey sign. You sex doctor bitches! And simply slamming the nose of Major Tom into that green mat. Trying to add a little Christmas red to it. Speaking of which, trying to bust open the Major. Both Cactus Jack and Major Tom putting their respectful championships on the line. Major Tom with the Missouri heavyweight. Oh, Cactus with a big splash with the power of the Coastal Territory heavyweight championship on the line for him. To the midsection, double arm DDT. That could very well be it. One, two, three. There you have it right there. That patella brain buster. That double arm DDT for the win. Legendary. Let's go to the official word and the best theme song ever, in my opinion, the IWA theme. Cactus Jack now the double gold holder of Missouri heavyweight division and still the Coastal Territory world heavyweight champion. Ah, that's a hell of a way to end this broadcast and from the birthday stuff. I want to thank each and every one of you for joining me here today on this rando last minute broadcast. I want to thank all the new faces here, the new subscribers, the new followers, the bits donators, the money donations. Thank you all so very much for joining me here today. This is a fantastic way to end the birthday days for me as I head into my 40. Thank you so much, John. Thank you, Drakeo. But yeah, I love you all so very much. Follow this channel if you haven't already. Follow me at HowdyPriceDW on Twitter, or X, whatever you want to call it. Be sure to catch me at twitch.tv/AndyEplays for W3, which should be back tomorrow, hopefully. If not, just stay tuned on that one. But be careful out there, folks. Wash your face, wash your hands, wash your ass, wear a mask. People are hacking up a lung, getting everybody sick. I don't want you to be sick. I want you to be happy and healthy for when you come back here so I can entertain you some more. But until then, I want to tell you again and again, thank you all so much for coming here and hanging out with me and supporting my silliness. And yeah, I just can't thank you all enough. I love you all so very much. This is Dino Woodward saying thank you, thank you, thank you. Take care of yourself and each other. And of course, OU 818.